Everyone, now today we are going for the experiment, that is PAM, pulse amplitude modulation. Now this is what the kit available here. This kit is for PAM. Now in the PAM we have the input frequency knobs. The connections has been done. We will use input frequency as 1 kilohertz and 500 hertz. Currently we are using frequency as 1 kilohertz, that is the input modulating frequency. So I can show you, this is given to the CRO channel 1. So here you can just see the frequency, I'll note it down for the very first. So this frequency is first reading, that is 959, I'll put in hertz. Okay, so this is around 1k. Then you can take a voltage. This voltage is 2.24 volt, so I'll take the reading here, just show the observation table also. So here I'll take the observation, that is 2.24 volt. So very first is my reading amplitude, and I have taken the frequency. Now I'll show you the carrier. So second, I'll off this, I'll on the second one. So this is what the carrier. So I can show you the carrier in a visible form. So this is what the carrier. So I'll take the reading for carrier. You can see the reading for the carrier here, the blue. We have a color CRO, so it will indicate the blue is the carrier. So you can have peak to peak voltage is 656 millivolt. So I'll write here. So it is in millivolt. So carrier voltage is 656 millivolt. And the frequency, you can see frequency here. Carrier frequency is 15.15. So carrier frequency, I'll write 15.15 kilohertz. So around, you can say, I'll on both. So you can see here both the frequencies. So this is what your carrier, the above one, and the yellow one is your frequency. So the readings we have taken, the same readings are here. Now this is the basic. Now we are going for the pulse amplitude modulation. So what we are doing, according to this carrier, the pulse amplitude is adjusted accordingly. So Dinesh, you just change the just show me the output. So from here, this is what input, I'll just put the output here, and the CRO I put in the run mode. Now here you can see here, this is my input, yellow one, and the blue one, this is my output. Okay, so the blue one, this is what my output. Now I'll overlap the input on the output. You can see that the input is adjusted accordingly. Now they are sampled. This is what my exactly input, the yellow one, and this is what high frequency component is in between, and according to the amplitude of your input, that is the carrier wave, so it is varied accordingly. So for both we can take down the reading. For input we have taken the reading, so input I'll make it off. I'll just take the reading for output, so you can take the reading for output. So here the frequency, you can take the frequency is for here, the frequency, it is again showing the output frequency, it is fluctuating. Okay, so as there is a fluctuation, so the frequency it is showing, just wait, I have to hold it. I'll just put it in the auto set, and accordingly this is upper one is the input. Now my interest is the yellow, my interest is this. So you can see this is fluctuating. So it is 15.15 15.5. So my frequency is 15.5, same as 15.15 initially. So this is what my frequency, and amplitude I'll take peak to peak. So that is 196 amplitude, 196 millivolt, and frequency is in kilohertz. Okay, so this is what the reading I am taking. Okay, so you just compare about the frequency. This is input frequency modulating signal around 1k, and this is around 15k. Same around 15k you are getting after modulation. Amplitude, there is the variation. Okay, that is in millivolt. Now I'll go further. Now this is what my input signal, that is in yellow. Here the yellow is the input signal. This is what my modulated signal. This way you have to plot on your graph both input and output. I have just shown you the overlapping, so it can be overlap. The same overlapping can be done. So here you can see the amplitude of this signal, that is the input signal yellow, it is change accordingly. Now we will go for the you can change it for the output. Now just we will go for the output. So you just check it for the output, you can have the changes. So here I have this output to here, that is filtered output I am shown here, and this is what my output. So I'll just, this is what my output, okay, the channel 2. So this output I'll note it down, what is my output I am getting. So your frequency you can note it down. So your frequency is 9, your frequency is a little bit fluctuating, so I'll just stop it. So you can take any reading, so I have stopped it. So that is 957 is my frequency hertz, and my voltage is 116 millivolt. So you can see the frequency is almost same. Okay, so whatever the frequency, now I'll show you the input, actual input. Now this is my input, and this is what my the output. So here this is what I'm moving. The blue one is output and the upper one is input. Now if I'll overlap both, so you can just see there is a phase difference. Why this delay? Because here in the kit, here you can see the delay. I'll put it across the axis so that you can see actually. Here you can see the, it is starting initially, the yellow one is the input signal, it is starting here. So the delay, phase delay is there. So why this delay? You can come to this kit. Now on this kit, this is PAM input, this is pulse amplitude modulation, this is your amplifier, and then this is what internally filtered and filtered output we are taking. So this electronic processing, it takes some delay, and this delay is introduced because when you will transmit, this transmission will be over the antenna, but here on the kit you are showing it on the same. So this one reading is complete. So this is what the one reading. Same we will go for the another reading, but here we will change the input frequency. Okay, so instead of around 1k we have taken the input frequency. I'll just go for the kit, and on the kit the input frequency is, instead of 1 I have taken the input frequency as 500. So you can just see here, I'll show you. So this is what my input frequency. Now input frequency, this is around 500. So the frequency is around 500. The fluctuation is there little bit. So 479 is my frequency, 479 hertz, and my voltage is around 5 volt. So that is what amplitude is, 4.92 volt. Okay, this is my input. Now I'll go for the output. Go for the carrier. The carrier, what I am putting, carrier as same. Now here I'll take the same carrier. So this is what my carrier frequency. So I'll do the auto set. I'll show you the carrier frequency. I'll do manually. So this is what the blue one is, my carrier frequency. So this is what my carrier frequency, here you can see. Okay, this is carrier frequency. So around 15 point something. So I'll stop this. So 15.33. So reading I'll take 15.33 is my reading, same as the previous, that is 15.15. little bit fluctuations are there. And the time, the voltage, that is what it is in millivolt. So that is 544 millivolt. Same. Now I'll go for the output. Okay. So same blue frequency. Now I'll change it to the output. So show me the modulated output. Only what I change, I change the input frequency. So here you can see. And I'll just, this is what I'll take first the reading and then accordingly. Now here you can see the again this frequency is 15 point something. So 15.22, so I'll note it down. 15.22 is my frequency for carrier, and the time the voltage is 552. So it is around the same, 552 millivolt. Now I'll just check with the input. So this is my input. So you can check the overlapping, same. So I have changed the frequency, modulating frequency. Initially it was 1K, now it is around 500. So it is same exactly there. Now I'll go for the output. Okay. So I'll go for the output. So instead of this carrier, I'll go for output here. So the output is put, and now you can see here the output. I'll just show the output first. So this is what your output. Okay, so I'll take the noting for the output. So for the output, again your frequency is the same as the input, that is the frequency is 475.8, so 476 you can take. And here the peak to peak, that is 240 millivolt, that is 240 millivolt. So this reading we took. Now I'll show you the input. Again you can see here the delay. This is input starting here, output is starting here. So this is what the delay between input and output as previously. Now these are the reading I took. So you can see the, this is the input signal. So input signal around 1K, around 500. So this is, this reading I repeat now for what? My frequency is around 15 point something. That is the carrier frequency. So I have the option another. So I'll take the carrier frequency lower than this, and I'll do the reading. So I'll now change the carrier frequency. So here there is the function. So the jumper, if I'll change, so this is 16K if I'll have the lower jumper. The jumper I change to the upper side, that it is 8K. So 8K, and the modulating frequency I'm say taking it same, that is 500. So you can just check the frequency, the input I'll put it in the auto. So my I want the carrier frequency. So I have changed it to the carrier frequency. Okay, so what for the input, I'll take the same reading as that is my readings. You can do here input 4.92, around the same reading is there. and the frequency is the same 479, around the same, that is around 480 is the saving, 480, 481, 470, it is fluctuating. Okay, so I can put at the stop and I can take the reading. So this is what input. Carrier frequency I can take, so I'll just hide the input, I'll take the carrier. So the carrier frequency, this is what my carrier frequency, so I can note it down, the carrier frequency. So carrier frequency, you can see it is 7.75. so my carrier frequency is changed almost half of the previous 7.57, and the time, the peak to peak is 540 millivolt. Okay, so the carrier reading I took. So I took the carrier reading. Now I'll go for the amplitude modulation. So here again, from the input I'll go for the output. So this is PM output, I'll put it in this and you can check it out. So this is what your modulated signal. I'll take the reading, then I'll show compare with the input. So again, your frequency, you can check the frequency. So I'll do the auto set. So now I'll take the frequency, that is the modulated signal. So my modulated signal is same, the frequency is 7.765. So I'll take the frequency 7.765 kilohertz, and my peak to peak voltage is 5 to 8 millivolt. And now I can show you the input. I'll overlap with the input. So input I can overlap. So here you can see, okay, same as the modulating signal. Now I'll just go for the output. Now here, this is my modulated signal. Now I'll go for the filtered output demodulation. So after this, the demodulation, here I'll get the output. So I'll run it. So this is what my output. So here output, you can see around the 478, same as the previous. So 478 is the same frequency, and I'll show you the input. So the input is again 478. So here we can check it out. I'll just do the overlap. So overlapping, I'll show you. So here overlapping can be seen. Okay, so here you can see there is the delay. So it is starting here, that is input, and the delay is here. So you can see the delay. Amplitude I am taking, so that is 252. So I have taken the three reading, only one reading I need to take. So here the frequency, input frequency, I'll just change to the around 1k, that is 900 something, and I'll put the carrier frequency as same. So this will be my last reading. So quickly I'll go through that, the last reading. I'm taking four readings so that you can understand in thoroughly. So here, this is what my input. I'll take the reading for the input, and my output I'm saying, that is the carrier. So I'll show you first the input. So this is what my input. So input, you can just see. So that is input frequency is 965. Two fixed output are inputs are available, and voltage is one around 2, that is 1.96. okay, then I'll show you the carrier. So this is what my carrier frequency. So the carrier frequency is same, that is 7.575. okay, and my voltage is 5540, that is same as previous. Now I'll go for the output. So here I'll just change the output from here to the output of PAM. I just do it, and same frequency I'll get here. You can see 7.71. So 7.71, and the voltage is 188. Okay, so I can show you with the input. It is overlapping. Okay, so you can see it is overlapping. The quality is degraded. You can see that because the carrier frequency is lower. So if it is more, then it will be the better quality. Okay, now I'll go for the output. So here, from the PAM, I'll go for the output here, and I'll show you the output. So this is what, first I'll take the output voltage and reading. Again, the thing is same, that is 5. The frequency is 959.6 and 106 millivolt is the reading. I'll show you the input. So again, you can see that it is overlapping. Here you can see again the delay. So this way you can see all the four readings we have taken. The frequency initially we have taken, that is for the around 1K, 500K, 500K, and then 1K. Carrier frequency, the initially 15.5 around, and then 7.7. So this way we took the four reading. So this is about the pulse amplitude modulation experiment. Thank you.